Hey gang, John Backrelli here with your Lake St. Clair Fishing Report, brought to you by Sportsmen's Direct. It is Wednesday, July 17th, and I got a cold front coming in, thankfully. Water temp at Belle Isle is 76 degrees. Look back at the last report, which was about 2 weeks ago, and water temperature was 70 degrees. So we are up to 76 degrees right now, which is sometimes the warmest temp that we might see all year. So I think it's kind of safe to say that we've got kind of a August pattern going on right now out there on the lake. But I do expect, I don't think that water temp's going to hold right there. I think she's going to come down a couple few degrees this week. Weather for this week, we have got kind of a major change coming, and it's actually happening out there right now. We got a pretty good north wind blowing out there right now, and we have much cooler temps on the way, and maybe tonight down into the low 60s, and then maybe tomorrow night and next couple of nights maybe even into the 50s, which will feel fantastic, and you'll be able to turn those AC units off and open some windows up, and it's also going to help cool the lake down. I guess I get these out of the way here right off the get-go. Shout out to Jack Tyndall for sending in some beautiful smallie pics. These were actually from about a week ago out there on the lake. We had just some great conditions Jack had for some taking some pictures and shot some beautiful pictures with some great skyline backgrounds in there. And also a shout out to Chris Hicks and his son for another great smallie pics. It seemed like the last couple of weeks, everybody's had smallies on the mind, and I guess that's not hard to believe with what we had going on out here, because we just had the big Bassmaster Open out here just this last week, okay? And for any of you guys that follow the Bassmasters, it was a huge event. I know some of you guys stayed away, especially on the weekend, thinking it was still a huge event, but that event went from like Thursday, Friday, Saturday. It was an elimination event. They had 200 plus boats, and then they had like another 170 co-anglers or non-boaters that fished with those guys for the first 2 days. And those guys really put up some impressive numbers up there almost a good majority of the guys was up on the north end of the lake. And I honestly didn't think it was going to get one up there on the north end of the lake, but it really did. And they put together some impressive bags up there. I think it was just under 75 pounds, I think, for 3 day total for the winning bag. But some very impressive weights, especially for this time of the year. And if you want to hear some really good details about how those guys did it as far as the techniques they were employing, you can go check out Joe Bauer, Smallmouth Heaven Guide Service. I know he did a video, I'm pretty sure it's out there on YouTube, but he definitely posted it up on his Facebook page, and we'll try to add a link in, I guess, here at some point. He explains kind of the technique they were using. Pretty much they were running and gunning using forward-facing live scope sonar. So, makes for exciting TV, but it really doesn't make for exciting fishing when you're watching it, because it's basically, watching electronics, and then speeding along with the electric trolling motor, and then casting to the fish you want to catch. At least that's the technique basically that the guys were using for catching, the big bags. And then, like I said, Joe goes into much more detail. Basically, they were throwing small or medium to light jig heads with either paddle tail swim baits or with some straight tail minnows on there for a lot of the fish that were caught. So, anyways, check out Joe's video on it. He goes into a lot of detail, and I'm going to try to have Joe on here in the near future, and we'll talk about a lot of other things smallmouth related out here on the lake. A lot of big fish caught, some great weights, 22 pounds basically all the way down to like the top 50. So lake is fishing pretty good right now for smallies if you employ the correct techniques. Now, with the water temps as warm as what they are, and like I said, we're basically in a August pattern right now, you guys should really be focusing out considerably deeper. There's definitely fish out there by the channel. There's fish out there in those deeper weed beds, deeper than 12 feet. Yes, you can catch a lot of, you can still catch numbers in shallower, but those quality fish are going to be out deeper right now. The weeds are very mature out there, so you've got a lot of offshore structure for these fish, and they prefer to be out where it's a little deeper, and especially when it's away from all the boat activity, as you know that we have out there on Lake St. Clair. So shout out to Max Lasky. He's another charter captain that we followed in the past. Max seems to really have the muskies dialed in out there right now, posted some great pics of the muskies that they're getting, and also some, back to the smallie thing again, some big smallies too. And I gotta wonder if those smallies were chasing some of those baits at 3+ miles an hour and smacked maybe some bigger eight or 10 inch musky baits out there, which they will do sometimes. So what I didn't say about the guys fishing the Bassmaster Open is they're generally fishing smaller baits now. That seems to be the thing out here. At least that's the way the market is going. More of a finesse presentation, sneaking up on those fish with the electronics, and then hitting them with a smaller, easily edible bait. And so, you know, like 2.5 to 3 inch tops, kind of in that finesse category, compared to what the musky trollers are doing with those, you know, 8 and 10 inch baits at 3.5 miles an hour, using the twin screws or single screws on their big trolling rigs out there, making noise. You know, exact opposite of what you're going to do in a finesse presentation situation. So shout out to Max again, great pictures, and keep them coming. So talking a little more specifics about out here on the lake, we haven't got a lot of activity because of the just wonderful weather we had, other than the great weather that the guys did have last week going into that Bassmaster Open. We've had so many like rainstorms and wind and all kinds of crazy stuff, but those fish are still out there, guys. There's still fish out there in the dumping grounds, whether it's smallmouth, walleyes, or perch. There's still fish out by the lighthouse in and around those buoys. We are getting some reports now up on that north end of the lake, up by that B marker, a little bit of a mixed bag going on. And then like the Bassmasters were doing, up in those areas where the different channels are feeding down into the lake, that's bringing some cooler water down there. And those fish this time of the year, especially up in Anchor Bay, will move up and set up shop out into that middle area of Anchor Bay and up in those channels and even up in those channel cuts. And I mean, that's definitely part of the summer pattern for that end of the lake. For us down by the mile roads, that summer pattern is those fish kind of move offshore a little bit. They take up shop on some of that structure that's further offshore. Some of those fish go all the way out to the shipping channel. And then as you move down towards the Detroit River, obviously the shipping channel and the dumping ground, that's kind of the deep water or deeper water offshore structure for all those fish down through that Grosse Pointe area. So, you know, the summertime pattern for sure. However, we've still had some reports, and this goes against the grain in a way, of walleyes being caught right out in front of the spillway and in the spillway. Same thing with the muskies. And the muskies, I mean, that's pretty normal for them to be out there in front of the spillway. But I was really surprised to see videos, and I wish I had one for you guys here, but I saw a video that Lucas shot earlier this week of, I think maybe a week ago, of a big muskie, like a 50-incher, literally coming up right next to his kayak while he was in the spillway right up by the dam. So, and that was after one of those big rains that we had. So even though the water is warm, and I guarantee you that water in that spillway after it's getting fed in there, after pouring down off of the highways and everybody's backyards and parking lots and everything, all that water coming out of the spillway is really warm, and you still got fish like muskie and walleye in the spillway right now. So, you know, that water temperature doesn't completely turn them off. If there's food there, food always wins the battle. So if you find the food, and I've said that plenty of times before, you find a lot of these species of fish out there on St. Clair. Let's see, what else do I want to talk about here? I know Jerry Toner posted out there. She was catching fish, and I know she's normally down there on that south end of the lake, so I'm going to guess those fish were out by the dumping grounds, perch and smallies. So like I said, those areas have still got fish out there, folks. So you got good, healthy weed beds out there. You're out in some a little bit cooler water. It's deeper, and it's part of that offshore pattern that we got going on right now out on Lake St. Clair. If you are trolling for walleyes out there right now, and there's not a lot of you guys trolling for walleyes, but there are guides like Garrett Samsel that will still target them at this time of the year. And I know Garrett just they boasted a really beautiful walleye for the summertime. And it's not uncommon in the summertime to really get some of these big fish out there. And this one looked to be like in a 30-inch, you know, 30-inch class. That's really big for the summertime. But I have heard of several fish in that 27-inch class that have been coming out by that lighthouse area, mixed in with all those perch. And if you are trolling eyes at this time of the year, if you get clean enough water conditions, meaning you don't have too many weeds up on top, try running those bandits or those other crankbaits up high above those weed tops. Get them set up so they're just ticking and ripping through the tops of those weeds. Same thing with your inline crawler harnesses. Run those crawler harnesses up, set them so they're just ticking the weed tops out there, and I think you'll have some success, especially on days when you got a little bit of water movement, like we have right now with that north wind would be perfect. And if it continues tomorrow, and I think it will, it'll tend to lay some of those weeds down a little bit lower, and so it kind of gives you more working area between the surface and where those weeds are and where those fish will set up. And it could be good out there tomorrow for walleyes if we get that, get a little bit of motion out there, motion on the ocean that we haven't had in a long time. It's been a little bit flat and been a little bit tough kind of conditions for the walleyes out there. But yeah, don't be afraid to get those inline sinkers going and work above the weed tops out there for those eyes. The other thing that you need to do right now with all that rain that we've had, okay, is really look out there, pay attention when you're running for a lot of logs and debris. And I've heard it from multiple people on multiple locations out on the lake, big areas of debris, logs. You don't know what's going to get washed in when we have those deluges like we've had in the last couple of weeks. Now this north wind, the positive side, what's happening right now out there as I'm doing this report with that north wind, and tomorrow that will help flush the lake out, and hopefully by the weekend all that stuff will be out and on its way down to Erie. So but just keep that in the back of your mind if you're running around out there. Pay attention, keep your eyes open, and we don't need anybody blasting a hole in their hull or messing up an out drive or anything out there. Trying to think if there's anything else for the report this week. I think I covered what I wanted to. Pretty short. It's middle of the summer. There's not a lot that changes out there. So I'm probably only going to be doing these reports like every other week right now. So don't get too disappointed. Don't be waiting for a report every week. Probably not going to come unless things dramatically change. So great weather ahead going into this weekend. If you have a chance, get out there and enjoy the little bit cooler temperatures that we're going to have out on St. Clair. Hey gang, if you like our content, hit the little subscribe button and the bell icon, and you'll be notified as soon as we put out new stuff. Hey gang, John Backrelli here with your Lake St. Clair Fishing Report, and I don't even know what day it is. So, well, July 17th.
Imagine that.
There you go. We'll try that again.